I'm a huge fan of using shapes and lines on Canva to create your own original logos because you could trademark those. If you're using Canva's fonts, shapes, and lines, they become your original creations. We've created this fashion logo using shapes, lines, and fonts, and the 3D logo ended up looking like this. So jump in with me so we can create this logo together. Before we jump in on Canva and start designing, I urge you to go visit canva.com/help/trademarks-logo and then have a look at the rules that you need to follow when you're creating logos on Canva and how can it be an original, when can you trademark it, and most of all, when can you use your shapes and line and pictures in order for you to be designing logos on Canva. Link it in the description below as well so that you have it and you are educated when it comes to you creating logos on Canva. Now we're going to jump in and create the logo. You're going to scroll down and you're going to create a blank logo canvas. Next step is to change the background of our canvas and make it a dark color, so whichever color that you want to use. Then you're going to go to your shapes and your lines and start your creation. We're going to start with our hat. Therefore, we're going to be using an arch up shape. We click on it once and we add it to the design, and then we change the color and make it whatever color you want. You're always welcome to use the styles on Canva to help you with the coloring, and then you make the shape of this arch up nice and hat like. Next, we grab a circle from our shapes and we squeeze it to create the hat-like look of our design. This is a design choice. I'm going to add a line so that I can create a nice line hat on my head. So you could decide to do this or not. Move that over to your head, zoom in to see a little bit better. And then you change the color and make it a gold, and then you change the end points and make them round, and it looks like that. So we zoom out. Next, we're going to create a face. We make the shape egg-like and we make the color of her face cream. We squeeze it, we make an oval shape, we add it to the head, and then we send it to back. So you select the oval shape and then you position and you send it to back. Then you have her face like that. We're gonna add earrings. We're going to select a square and squeeze the square to create a beautiful dress, and with different colors of the dress. And then we create another square for the arm. Our next step is to add this shape that's called trapezoid up on our design, and then it has that nice waist that we can use and it looks like a dress. So you're gonna align it nicely to the waist on your design. Go and grab create it over there and then put it over on her waist as a belt and align it quite nicely. And I'm going to now add her arms. Then I'm going to press L for line, or go and grab a line on my shapes over there and then make my arm have a rounded end. In other words, go to my end points and make it round, and then start making the weight of this line a bigger size so that it fits a potential arm. I'm going to change the color and make it the cream color of the person that we're designing, and then I have an arm. So I will adjust the arm and add an arm on both sides. And we're going to lastly create the dress and make it look dress-like. Therefore, we're going to scroll down and go find the cloud shape and add it on there, and then start creating a dress-like look on our dress. So you're going to squeeze that, make it smaller, and then add it to your dress. And she's wearing her dress, and the photo or the creation of the young lady is done, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to group everything. So I would highlight everything and group it, and it's one picture, and then make it a little bit smaller so that the icon is smaller, and then I can start adding the name of the company. And there you go, beautifully done, created a fashion logo, all shapes used on Canva. Now you're ready to convert it to a 3D logo. You're going to click on your share, you're going to select download. This time we're not going to use PNG because it pixelates. We're going to use the SVG because it's best for web design and animation and logos if you're going to be converting them to 3D. You're going to be using a transparent background. Take note, transparent background as well as SVG is only available on Canva Pro. If you want to go test it out, you're more than welcome to go to my link below and go try it out, as well as the pixelation that really drove me insane. Once it's downloaded, if you've missed that video where I was showing you the SVG quality, go find it. I'll link it below and above. Next, we're going to open Photopea online, and then we're going to convert our 2D SVG file to a 3D logo using Photopea. Once we land on www.photopea.com, we're going to select templates. I found this beautiful black wall 3D logo mockup created by Graphics Family. You just click and you open the mockup, and then you open it using the link. Then you're going to go to the right hand side and double click where it says your logo here on the checkered box. You just double click over there, and then the example you hide by clicking on the eye. And then you can drag your SVG file to the canvas and then align it so that you can convert it. And we press Command S or Control S on Windows to convert it to a smart object. And we click on the first tab to go and find our converted 3D logo. And it's beautiful and it looks like that. Download your design. You're gonna go File, Export As, and you can choose the type of file that you want to download. We choose PNG and then we export the file. If you've missed the SVG video, that's the next thing that you need to go watch. Why we get quality conversion when we use SVG. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.